with a 50% increase in overall spending by the Department of Communications, Climate Action and the Environment, an extra €500 million for infrastructure or capital spending by the Department of Transport, and a ring-fenced increase of €7.50 per tonne in the carbon tax to encourage more climate-friendly fuel use, this was a big budget day for the environment.
In raising it consistently over 10 years to €100 a tonne, which we have legislated for, we will legislate for this evening, that it has to be a just transition.
€100 million from the carbon tax money will be used for grants to improve energy efficiency in homes, with some of the remainder funding a €3.50 per week increase in social welfare fuel allowances and a €5 per week increase in the living alone allowance.
Because of the eligibility criteria for the fuel allowance, that might not be enough to cushion the blow of the carbon tax on those people. And there's a few months now before that comes in. It doesn't come into May of next year for solid fuels.
Changes to vehicle registration tax, which will make higher emission cars significantly more expensive in line with climate action priorities, have also been introduced. A new motor tax structure for new cars from January will also embrace the polluter pays principle.
Quite clearly, the government have laid out that they want to move towards electrified vehicles, electrified in hybrid electric and also electric and plug-in electric. That's a very clear signal. They want to reduce nitrous oxide and they want to reduce CO2.
The extra €500 million for transport investment will enable significant progress on public transport initiatives, including Bus Connect, Metrolink and the DART expansion programme, as well as 41 additional intercity rail carriages. George Lee, RTE News.